storm. Arndon's by the three quarters and one, 24, four fifths. Del Miller with the son of Arnie Elmerhurst taking aim on the world's record. Here comes Arndon trotting to the wire, officially programmed to beat 156, four fifths. Del Miller and Arndon. Hall of Famer Del Miller with Arndon trotting to the wire. Time of the mile, 54 flat. Ladies and gentlemen, you have just witnessed the fastest mile by a trotter, any age, anywhere, anytime, any sex. Arndon, the fastest trotter ever, 154 flat.
The outstanding trotter Arndon, and yet another triumph for prominent New Zealand owner Mr. Roy McKenzie. The tradition of success enjoyed by his family for 60 odd years began with the late JR or Sir John McKenzie. His foresight and judgment saw two outstanding stallions imported to New Zealand. Light Brigade was one of those. A docile, intelligent type, he established all sorts of records. Top sire for 4 years and a top broodmare sire for 8. Hugh Scott was another, a fiery individual with brilliant speed and stamina. A leading sire 9 times and broodmare sire on 10 occasions. His progeny won over 400 races from some 2,000 starts. In more recent times, the Mackenzie stud Roydon Lodge, named after Sir John's sons Roy and the late Don, has seen the straight-out trotting stallion Game Pride continue that dominance. A champion sire on 2 occasions, his performance is more remarkable when considering the ratio of trotting races to paces at most meetings. The current boom stallion is Smoothfella, whose progeny are now dominating the Australasian results list. But despite the widespread success of these stallions and their progeny, one race has eluded the McKenzie family horses. And that race is the New Zealand Trotting Cup.
Well, after all these years, does one tend to think that perhaps the McKenzie family is jinxed with the New Zealand Cup?
Well, I think you could say that. We've been trying for an awful long time. Jinxes are made to be broken. Let's break it if we can.
How many times has the family come close to winning the New Zealand Cup?
About 5 or 6 times. The first time, I think my father might have almost won it with great Bingen, but they didn't have the photographs of the finish at that stage. So that came within a nose of being a victory. We've had a few thirds and fourths, I think. The nearest probably would have been Gus on Rue when he was brought down with 2 furlongs to go.
Roydon Scott was obviously a horse with a tremendous amount of ability. Did you believe he would win the New Zealand Cup?
Yes, at one stage I thought he could have won the New Zealand Cup. The last one he was in, while he was a bit sore, and he didn't get away. He didn't have that opportunity, but he had the ability to win one.
But now there's another McKenzie prospect, a horse with the ability to attract crowds, a horse with a race performance unmatched in recent years by any other performer, the latest star on the New Zealand trotting scene, and yet another product of the famed Roydon Lodge. Roydon Glen, by Smoothfellow out of Roydon Girl, gives Roy McKenzie a golden opportunity to win the New Zealand Cup. He's fit, he's ready, and he's willing to take on anyone, and no wonder on this performance.
Everything he has done as a 4-year-old has been outstanding. He puts his reputation on the line. Everything tonight is against him. He's drawn the barrier 9, and it is going to be a difficult job for him to win the Messenger Final.
One horse in it, and at the moment is Roydon Glen. He's out by 5 or 6 lengths from Comedy Lad. Slugger and Barnes Glory battling it out for third. King Elba coming down well, and down on the inside, Lucy Lumber. At the 150, Roydon Glen, 5 lengths on Comedy Lad. King Elba coming in a big run down the outside. They go to the line, though, and Roydon Glen, he's got it won.
Can number 7, Roydon Glen, can he give Roy McKenzie another Auckland Cup win tonight?
Onto the lane comes the hottest favourite in years. Roydon Glen going for his 10th on the end. He's out by 4 lengths at 200. Hilarious Guest is running second, Deep Bookie Flex, and Enterprise is having another go. Almana finishing well down the outside. Roydon Glen is starting to stop a bit. Hilarious Guest second. Comedy Lad coming on well. Wider right up to Almana. But Roydon Glen has got the cup on as Hilarious Guest closed on him.
Roydon Glen going for 11 in a row. He's out by 2 lengths. Almana tracking him. Is he going to be able to bridge the gap? Fred's got the whip on Roydon Glen, and Almana's out to challenge. 100 to go. Roydon Glen, oh, but he's kicking away. Roydon Glen, the little champ, 11 in a row. He wins the Pan Am. Vile for 1985, a brilliant performance. He asked Roydon Glen to lengthen out, and he's three lengths in front of Freightman. Can't keep up with him. Kind Nature's angled out, and Camelot's three wide round the bend. Enterprise chasing him. They straighten up, 300 metres to go. Roydon Glen clear, out by three lengths. Camelot's charging home well. Freightman still there. Enterprise putting in a big run, and further into Spry Joker and Kind Nature. But Roydon Glen, he's back to his brilliant best. He's coasting down towards the line. Fred Feature keeping him going down towards the post. He's two lengths in front of Freightman, who's chased him all the way, but Roydon Glen's won it.
After breaking at the start, he's played the leader. Past the four, Roydon Glen by two over premiership. Enterprise and Almana and hands down and Mighty Me. Round the bend they come, and Roydon Glen is the leader. It's Roydon Glen by two lengths over premiership, and Enterprise trying to rally. Roydon Glen in front, premiership trying to come again on the inside. Roydon Glen by a length from premiership, and Enterprise and Almana. It's Roydon Glen being kept up his whip by a length and a half now. And Roydon Glen is going on to win it by premiership, and Enterprise coming at him now. And they've gone to the line, and Roydon Glen has just won it by a head.
Of all the horses that you've been involved with, possibly the horses that the McKenzie family have been involved in from your memory, do you think Roydon Glen will be remembered as perhaps the greatest?
I think at this stage he is the best one they've had, and hopefully will be the best.
It's always hard to win one, but if you've got a good horse and things go right, such as we have with Roydon Glen, after that first furlong, if everything's gone well, I think we'll have a good show.
Of the horses, the owners of the horses who are sitting in the grandstand, and the many punters who have followed their fancies with their money. Camelot, last year's winner, going from 10 metres along with Hands Down, starts from the unruly position. Pre Chevalier going from number 8. The cup field almost set for a start. Lord Louis, Spry Joker, the second row. They're off and running in the New Zealand Cup. And Roydon Glen on the inside stepped out slowly but safely. Pre Chevalier has gone into a bit of a skip at the back of the field and settled back a little. Camelot's made a good beginning, Hands Down. Spry Joker's broken up, and Lord Louis was slow early. Premiership has dashed out to the lead. Premiership has dashed into the lead from Ben, followed by Comedy Lad and Freightman. Almana back on the inside, then Enterprise. It was followed by Bo Rana with Roydon Glen back on the rails. About three lengths to Mighty Me, two to Pre Chevalier. A bit further back, four or five lengths to Camelot was followed by Hands Down. And three lengths to Lord Louis and Spry Joker, the best part of 80 or 90 metres away. Now the New Zealand Cup field, they come round the bend into the straight for the first time. And the leader, Premiership, the black with the white harness, out in front by a length and a quarter. Ben trails the leader. Freightman's facing the wind over on the outside. Comedy Lad is three deep along the rail, followed by Almana. Roydon Glen's improved his place. He's down on the rails, followed by Enterprise. Mighty Me is trying to follow Roydon Glen through. Then Bo Rana as they pass the jump, two laps to go. Next is Pre Chevalier, being nicely held together, following Bo Rana, making up the little ground he lost. Camelot's got onto his back, followed by Hands Down and Lord Louis at the tail of the field. They go to the back now with 2,200 metres left to go. And the leader, Premiership, by a length and a half to two lengths from Ben, trailing. Freightman's out without cover in the outside, running third. Comedy Lad fourth the rail. Almana's sitting in the 1-1 position, followed by Roydon Glen, and there's Pre Chevalier. Round the outside he goes with 2,000 metres to go. Almana in the centre. Roydon Glen is locked up on the inside of Enterprise. Mighty Me, then Bo Rana, followed by Hands Down along the rail. Camelot the outside and Lord Louis, but Premiership takes them down to the 1800 metres now. It's Premiership, it's a steady pace in the cup. Pre Chevalier is elected to sit parked on the outside of his wheel. Ben trails the leader. Freightman gets some cover next on the outside as they approach the halfway point. Comedy Lad the rail. Almana and Roydon Glen were next, followed by Enterprise and Mighty Me. In behind those came Bo Rana. It was followed by Hands Down, tucked away on the fence. Camelot is second to last, and Lord Louis is the first to go around them. They race round the bend into the straight now, 50
1,500 metres left to go. And Premiership, the leader by two lengths, Ben, with Pierre Chevalier sitting on the outside. Barry Perkins has a nice grip on him. He's going well. Freight Man is following the Australian champion. Comedy Lads, the inside. Here's Lord Louis starting to smoke up three wide round Almana. Roydon Glen is tucked away on the rails. Camelot is following Lord Louis around Mighty V on the fence. Hands down has got out to follow Camelot, a lap from home. In the centre, Enterprise looking to get into the clear. And Borana biding his time at the back of the bunch, and they're four wide as they go round the Toyota Marquee turn. Into the bend they go now with just on and 1,000 metres to go. 1,000 left, and Premiership leads them into the back, and there's Hands Down going around them at double speed. Pierre Chevalier's in the centre. They were followed by Ben. At the 900 pole, Freight Man was next. Lord Louis, three wide. Almana in the centre. Comedy Lad, the rail. Camelot, three out. Royden Glen's tucked away on the inside of Borana. Then Enterprise and Mighty Me. A bunched field. Anybody's race going down the back. Premiership, the leader, Anthony Butty's looking over his right shoulder, and he's got Pierre Chevalier sitting alongside him. 600 metres to go. Ben on the inside. Wider out. Hands Down's being mopped up. He's not doing much. Here's Camelot making his charge wide. Comedy Lad back on the inside. Almana through the centre. Freight Man just ahead of him. Royden Glen can't get out. He's right back on the inside. Borana, Lord Louis retreating, and Mighty Me round towards the home turn. 300 metres left in the cup, and Premiership lines them up. Here's Pierre Chevalier attacking, and Camelot is three wide. They were followed by Ben in the trail and Freight Man. It's Premiership, 200 metres to go. Pierre Chevalier's under the stick. He's trying to wear Premiership down. Camelot's trying to dive bomb him. And here's Borana. Borana down the outside has got up. Pierre Chevalier's been headed off. And Borana's going away. And Almana's coming with him. And Royden Glen is flying home. But Borana's won the 1985 Toyota New Zealand Cup. We've got Royden Glen very wide out. Almana in the centre. Pretty tight for second and third. Almana may have beaten Royden Glen home. Comedy Lad, Pierre Chevalier, Premiership, Camelot, Freight Man, in behind them Lord Louis, followed then by Hands Down, Ben, Enterprise, Mighty Me, and Spry Joker.
Well, it goes to show you just how hard it is to win the New Zealand Trotting Cup. There you have one of the biggest upsets of all time, perhaps, with a 76-1 shot. Borana getting home to win the race and win it so impressively. A great performance, a great drive by Peter Jones. He won it aboard Hands Down. He wins his second New Zealand Trotting Cup, and didn't he do it in style? Let's have a look at the final stages, as called by John May.
Well, this is a bolter of the century. There's Premiership on the inside, but he's under a drive. Pierre Chevalier now. Barry Perkins gets anxious, one off the fence. Camelot in the green colours coming down the outside. Look for the runs of Almana and Borana in the black and white on the outside, and isn't he doing it well? And further out again, Royden Glen storming home. But they get down towards the finish, and Barana's got the cup. There's no two ways about it. He's going away from them. Almana is going to run second. Pierre Chevalier might be lucky to hold on for third, because Royden Glen is flying. But the judge is going to call the camera for the third and fourth placings, but you can put the ring around Borana. He's won the cup and won it superbly well.
So that is the situation here, with Borana confirmed the winner of the New Zealand Trotting Cup, and the applause is thunderous out here. Borana and Peter Jones. We'll bring you more details, the official placings, in one moment.
Well, there it is. Nobody can quite believe it, but it's happened, and there's no two ways about it. The official placings have just gone up on the board. Three, Borana is the winner. Four, Almana is second. One, Royden Glen, desperately unlucky in many respects, has run third. And eight, Pro Chevalier, is officially fourth. No details of the time yet, but they didn't look to be doing too much, and it's fairly average at 4:11.1. So just an average time, 4:11.1, and that's Borana's winning time in the 1985 Toyota New Zealand Cup.
Three very happy people here, Mr. and Mrs. Pat Murray, and you've travelled a long way from Dunedin, Mosgiel, and believe it or not, you told me last night you thought you might have had a chance.
You didn't believe me, did you?
Well, it's $76 to one, unbelievable, but a tremendous performance. You must be very, very excited.
Very much so, Philip. Yep, we said to you last night we'd only need to be a wee bit lucky and we'd have a show.
Well, Peter Jones did the work out there too with the horse, and a tremendous drive by you, Peter. Were you feeling confident all the way, or is that a stupid question?
Not with Pro Chevalier there, no one could be confident, no. No, but he did, he felt real good today, and
turning for home, well, I couldn't believe it when they come back so quickly, you know, and next minute you're in front and you think, oh, gee.
Well, congratulations, Peter. It's great to win a second New Zealand Cup. And to you, congratulations. You can enjoy now the success of winning a New Zealand Trotting Cup.
Thank you, Philip.
There we are. Well, the happy owners and driver-trainer, Peter Jones, have won the New Zealand Cup with Barana. Let's go to dividends now with John.
Well, they're up and they're mighty if you're on them. Number three, Barana, paid $76.65 to win and $12.55 the place. Number four, Almana for second, $4.60. Number one, Roydon Glen for third, $1.95. Quinella three and four, $258.90. And you can see the trifecta there, three, four and one, a mammoth $5,817.90.